Welcome to RSSDI TV 2018 Ahmedabad. I am Dr. Shahu Ingole and you are watching me live on therightdoctors.com and the RSSDI TV brought to you by Workout Pharmaceuticals. I am honored to have with me the most eminent endocrinologist from Karnal, Dr. Sanjay Kalra sir from Bharati Hospital Karnal. So welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you and good day, friends.
Sir, if we talk about the pathophysiology of the diabetes mellitus, we wanted to know your viewpoints on the role of glucagon in the pathophysiology.
We've come a long way from the initial days when we used to think that it is only the beta cell dysfunction which would modulate diabetes. We now know of the ominous octet, we know of the dirty dozen, and we know that glucagon or the alpha cell plays an important role in the pathophysiology of diabetes. So it's not so much of a structural defect as a functional defect. The alpha cell does not know when to turn on its secretion of glucagon. It doesn't know when to switch off the secretion of glucagon. And this is one of the defects of diabetes. We must also remember that as opposed to other hormones, which have usually negative feedbacks, sometimes positive feedbacks, glucagon is a free-running secretion. There is some kind of stimulus in the central nervous system which makes glucagon run, but we still do not know what that is. And therefore, it's slightly more difficult for us to unravel the importance of glucagon in the pathophysiology of diabetes. All said and done, it is a central player in this syndrome.
So, sir, what role is played by glucagon as a diagnostic agent or as a therapeutic agent in the management of the diabetes mellitus?
Glucagon historically has been used as a diagnostic agent in many aspects of not only endocrinology, but gastroenterology as well. In the past, our gastroenterology colleagues have used it to facilitate good quality barium enemas, to facilitate good quality ERCPs. We have used it as a test for hypoglycemia, as a test for etiology of hypoglycemia. And we also do glucagon challenge tests to check for C-peptide and then to assess whether a patient has type 1 or type 2 diabetes. However, its main role is in therapy. Glucagon is available as an injection for use for the treatment of hypoglycemia. It is also now available intranasally, though that preparation is not available in India. And it is also now a part of some bi-hormonal pumps. So instead of insulin pumps, the latest generation pumps now carry both insulin and glucagon to prevent hypoglycemia and to minimize glycemic variability.
So sir, we wanted to understand from you what role is played by glucagon in the clinical decision making.
Everybody with type 2 diabetes is a different individual, a different personality with a unique pathophysiology. What we learn from glucagon is that we should not view insulin or glucagon as separate hormones. We should not view the beta cell or the alpha cell as separate endocrine organs. Instead, we should have a holistic or a holonymous approach to diabetes, which means that we should consider them as part of the same fulcrum. We should look at the relative concentrations of insulin and glucagon before deciding what therapy to give. Insulin is the most potent anabolic hormone in the body. Glucagon is a catabolic hormone. Instead of talking about insulin deficiency or insulin resistance, we should actually be talking about insulin-glucagon ratios. A person with a low insulin-glucagon ratio would be a catabolic person. This person would benefit from insulin or, if possible, insulin secretagogues. A person with a high insulin-glucagon ratio would be somebody who is adaptive or rather maladaptive anabolic. So anabolic or maladaptive anabolic. Such persons will benefit from therapy like GLP-1 receptor analogs and SGLT2 inhibitors over and above metformin. If we understand this simple concept of looking at the patient from the viewpoint of a metabolic fulcrum or insulin-glucagon ratio fulcrum, it makes life much easier for us and it makes it easy for us to make appropriate pathophysiology-based, evidence-based decisions in the OPD.
Sir, what will be your key take-home message to all the practitioner diabetologists and endocrinologists as far as viewing the glucagon in from the different perspective of the diagnostic and therapeutic agent in diabetes?
We should be aware that injection glucagon is a life-saving drug, especially for people with type 1 diabetes who develop hypoglycemia. Ideally, glucagon should be available in every hospital, in every healthcare setting, in every public care setting, it should be part of every emergency kit. Every person who lives with type 1 diabetes, especially children and adolescents, should have glucagon handy. And their close ones, their family members, should know how to administer it in times of severe hypoglycemia.
So on behalf of Wockhardt Pharmaceuticals and RSSDI TV 2018, we thank you for your valuable time. So thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.